So, good morning, Mr. Guerra. So, our study, the group study, is a comparative study on the mode of transportation on the tardiness of university students. So, this study was conducted for the purpose of, firstly, or primarily for the group itself, because we, the group, has experienced a lot of issues with regards to our tardiness. Most of the group have private vehicles and some are just using public utility vehicles. So in this study, we would like to know that what is the best mode of transportation to lessen our tardiness in the university. So let's start our presentation.
So our group was able to come up with this following questions. The statement of the problem. This study was conducted to build a comparison between the mode of transportation and the tardiness of university students. Specifically, it aims to answer the following questions. First, what is the profile of the respondents? Second, what is the average number of tardiness of students taking private and public mode of transportation? Third is there a significant difference between the tardiness of students using public and private transportation? So at the end of this research, we'll be able to answer these following questions.
So for our statement of the hypothesis, there is no significant difference between the tardiness of students using public and private transportation. Next.
So in our study, this is our conceptual framework. Our independent variable is the mode of transportation. Under the independent variable is public vehicles and private. And so our dependent variable is tardiness of students.
Next is,
so we wanted to test the normality of both private vehicle and public vehicle. So our assumption shows that we, based on the significant value, is that it is 0.00. So therefore, we concluded that the test of our normality is not normally distributed. Our assumption is not normally distributed.
Criteria and procedure. The researcher used a self-made survey questionnaire to gather response. The likelihood for the recommendation was presented in the form of multiple choice scale. Sampling methods utilized in these studies were complete enumeration and systematic random sampling. The researchers asked the permission of the training manager of the respective institution. During the survey, the respondents were properly oriented to the objectives and benefits of this study. Next, here in Table 3, we present to you the cross-tabulation mode of transportation and tardiness. So here we can see the percentage of the students using private vehicles and students using public vehicles. In this table, we present to you the chi-square using the Mann-Whitey test. So this test was run through a application called SPSS.
So to conclude the study shows that the mode of transportation does not make a significant difference toward tardiness of the university students. Hence, the tardiness in attendance of the university students, including students from different divisions, namely SBG, SEA, SON, SOE, UMLET, CS, NSF, NSS, is not significantly affected by the mode of transportation. Therefore, going to school using private vehicles or public vehicles will not affect the tardiness or attendance of the students. So the implication for this study is that we, the researchers, have concluded that mode of transportation does not significantly affect the tardiness of the university students.